Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid demonstrates how to use rounding relations in the financial statements in CaseWare Financials. This video will demonstrate adding, modifying, and deleting rounding relations within the statements. Rounding relations are used to help balance the financial statements when minor discrepancies occur. These relations may be necessary due to decimals in the trial balance rounding to a whole number in the financial statements, thus creating differences. Rounding relations are designed to automatically resolve rounding issues in the financial statements by comparing balances in two cells and adding the difference to a specified third cell, the plug cell. Rounding relations affect only cells in the financial statements document and do not affect any numbers in the working paper's trial balance. In this video, we will add, modify, and delete a rounding relation using Financials Canada. To begin, open the Financial Statements document. Then select the Global Setup ribbon. Click on the Apply Relations link. The Rounding Relation pane appears. To add a new rounding relation, click on the Add a Rounding Relation icon. Type a label for the new relation in the Label field. I will call mine Rounding Relation QuickVid. Choose the first cell that you want to compare in the rounding relation by clicking the radio button next to cell A and selecting the cell in the financial statement. I will choose Total Assets for 2013. Next, choose a second cell to be compared in the rounding relation. Click the radio button for cell B, then in the financial statement below, click on the desired cell. In this case, I will choose total liabilities and equity for 2013. Now, define the plug cell to store the difference between cell A and B. Click the radio button next to cell C, then in the financial statements, choose the desired cell. I will use the Accounts Payable and Accrued Liabilities cell. If necessary, you can create conditional plug cells. A conditional plug cell allows you to select different cells to plug given different conditions. For information on how to do this, refer to our online help. Finally, in the Rounding Tolerance field, type the maximum allowed difference between cell A and cell B. I'm going to set the rounding tolerance to 5. This means that if the difference between cell A and cell B is within the rounding tolerance of 5, the difference will be accounted for in the accounts payable and accrued liabilities. Before I save, I'm going to consider what I've just inputted. If I double-click my cell A field, you can see the cell and the amount that it refers to, and same with cell B and cell C. Note that cell A and B are equal. Therefore, when this rounding relation is applied, we would not expect to see a difference in cell C. Knowing this, I'll click Save. The rounding relation specified has been added. To apply the relation, click the checkbox beside Apply Relations. As predicted, there are no changes because these values already balance. Let's take a look at what would happen if these values were not already balanced. I'm going to manually override my long-term investments, increasing its value by 3, so the total assets are actually higher than the total liabilities and equity by a difference of 3. Since this is still within my rounding tolerance of 5, the difference should automatically be added to the accounts payable and accrued liabilities cell. As expected, the accounts payable and accrued liabilities increased by 3 automatically, since the rounding relation is still applied. When I go back to my Global Setup ribbon and uncheck Apply Relations, the Accounts Payable and Accrued Liabilities no longer holds the difference between total assets and total liabilities and equity. I will now demonstrate modifying a rounding relation and the events that occur when a rounding relation is outside of the specified tolerance. To modify a rounding relation, click Modify a Rounding Relation and choose the rounding relation from the drop-down. The fields of any existing rounding relation can be modified the same way as adding the relation. I will rename mine to Rounding Relations Outside of Tolerance. Then I will change the tolerance to 2, which should prompt an error, as if you recall, the difference between cell A and cell B is actually 3. Click Save. Click the Apply Relations checkbox to apply the newly modified relation. The Recalculation Error dialog appears, explaining that the rounding difference exceeds the tolerance and the relation has failed to balance the cells. This will appear a few more times until you remove the checkbox from Apply Relations. You can modify the relation again to resolve the errors. Now that you have seen how to modify rounding relations and how they work within and outside of rounding tolerance boundaries, let's take a look at deleting a relation. To delete a relation, click the Delete a Rounding Relation icon. From the drop-down menu, select the appropriate relation. Then click Delete. When the warning appears, click Yes to complete the deletion, and the rounding relation will be deleted. This concludes the QuickVid on rounding relations. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.